something strange.
Come with us and you will see. This our town of Halloween.
This is Halloween. This is Halloween. Pumpkins scream in the dead of night.
This is Halloween. Everybody make a scene.
Trick or treat. Tell the neighbors.
Good evening and welcome to another frightening episode of Doctor Hazcom Laboratory. This evening's episode, Hazardous Communications. Now let's join Igor and Igor, already busy at work down in the lab.
Igor! Igor! What are you doing? Do you have any idea what these chemicals are or what they can do to you?
No, Dr. Hazcom!
These chemicals are very important to my experiment, but in the wrong hands, like yours, they could be extremely dangerous.
We didn't know!
You didn't know. You know, it's your right to know. That's what Hazardous Communications is all about. Your right to know what chemicals are in your workplace, what their hazards are, and what you can do to protect yourself against those hazards.
So where do we get this information?
Well, it all starts with the proper labeling of chemicals. Each of these little containers has an HMIS label on it, or Hazardous Material Identification System, that gives you information like certain health hazards the chemicals might have, the flammability of those hazards, the reactivity of that chemical, plus it tells us what protective equipment, or PPE, we need to wear when we're using those chemicals.
Mmm, pretty colors.
Igor, pay attention. This is important stuff. Now, when I'm working on my experiments, sometimes I need a little bit more information than the HMIS label can give me. That's where these come in. MSDSs, or Material Safety Data Sheets. They give us, in detail, specific information about the health hazards a chemical may contain. It gives us information on what to do if somebody's exposed from one of these chemicals, and how to protect ourselves from getting exposed in the first place.
I see. Pretty colors, technical papers, and I can't even read if I tried to.
That's why we have plenty of other things to identify hazards and chemicals. We have many other colorful labels that alert us to hazards in our chemicals. And also employee information sessions like this one, which educate employees about where to find out all this important information.
So what can these chemicals do to us anyways?
That's a good question, Igor. At least somebody's paying attention. Remember, chemicals can come in two different forms. Hazards come in two different forms. Physical hazards and health hazards. Explosions, fires, those are all physical hazards chemicals can have. But if you drink one of those chemicals into your body, that's called a health hazard.
All in these little bottles?
Well, chemicals can come in many forms. There's solids, like these welding rods, liquids, like this adhesive, and gases, like this oxygen.
So, I don't want to swallow the welding rod, and I'll be fine.
Oh, that's true. But ingestion's only one way that chemicals can enter our body. They can also enter our body through inhalation, or breathing it in, or contact with our skin. Both can be protected by using rubber gloves and a respirator.
So, breathing for a few minutes, be okay?
Well, different chemicals have different acceptable exposure limits. There's permissible exposure limits, PEL. Now that's the amount of time that somebody can be exposed to a chemical before it starts to affect their body. We also have threshold limit values, and that's the amount of time that you can be exposed to a chemical in a day before it starts to affect your body. And then lastly, we have the short-term exposure limits. And that's the STEL. An STEL is an acceptable exposure limit during a 15-minute period.
Wait! Wait! Too much information! PEL! NFL! ESPN!
Okay, alright. Just remember, some chemicals have an acute or short-term exposure limit, while other chemicals have a chronic or a long-term exposure limit.
So basically, you want to learn about all the chemicals around you.
You got it. Now, I'm expecting a very important package coming from Dead X. And it's going to be here any moment. You know what? That's going to give me just enough time to talk to the audience about another important aspect of Hazardous Communications. You guys stay here, accept that package, sign for it, but don't open it. Okay?
Okay!
DedX delivery for Dr. Hazcom.
Ooh.
You sign.
Cool.
You guys wait. Me lost arm last time I was here with you two idiots.
Okay.
Wait.
Now, before a brand new chemical can come into our company, there's a couple of important steps it must take first. Number one, the HS&E department must be notified of the purchase. Number two, a chemical pre-purchase identification form must be filled out by the HS&E department and the person who is attempting to purchase the chemical. Now what this does is this helps avoid duplication of chemicals. It avoids bringing in prohibited chemicals into the plant. Also ensures the proper PPE and engineering controls are in place before their use. It also ensures that the MSDS is obtained and filed. Speaking of MSDSs, this company has an MSDS for every chemical in the building. It's available 24 hours a day, and it's located in the main plant at the Wellness Center, and at the Post-Sale Center, and at the Module Center, close to their first aid rooms. Now lastly, whenever a chemical is found that cannot be identified, it must first be taken to the HS&E office for identification. Now once it's there, the HS&E people will attempt to identify the chemical and label it properly. Then, in some cases, it may have to be returned to the supplier, or in extreme cases, it'll have to be quarantined. Great Caesar's ghost! What has happened here? Have you two learned nothing from this show? Well, it's off to Nurse Marva's Wellness Center with the both of you!
No!
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 Not the Wellness Center!
Okay, here we are at the Wellness Center. Nurse Marva, can you look at Egor and Igor for a minute?
Just a minute.
Always waiting at the nurse's office. Wouldn't you know?
Thank you. Thank you very much, Marva.
Elvis has left the building.
Nurse Marva, can you take a look at my two assistants who have obviously been playing with chemicals again?
I'll do my best.
Now that we've got a minute to kill, let's talk about MSDSs. The MSDSs are available here in the Wellness Center 24 hours a day. And if you need to locate a certain MSDS, just use this easy-to-use MSDS directory. Let's see how Nurse Marva is doing with our two idiots. Nurse Marva, how's it coming along?
Almost done.
Let's see if Nurse Marva's ready now. Nurse Marva!
All done.
Igor! Igor!
What do you think, Dr.
Dr. Hazcom?
I hope you two have learned your lesson not to play with chemicals you know nothing about. And I hope you learned something, too. See you next time, kids.
I see you all made it to the end. Ha ha ha. Remember to join us next time for another exciting episode of Dr. Hazcom's Laboratory. If you dare.
I forgot where we left off!
Igor! Igor!
What do you think, Doctor something?
They got what? I thought we had professionals!